Good afternoon. This is for the first year and the subject food science, topic emulsions. We're talking about emulsions. You can see it is a mixture of two immiscible liquids where one liquid is dispersed over the other liquid. So I'll give an example. You can see this. There are two liquids in this. One is water, which is a continuous phase, as well as the oil droplets, which is said to be a dispersed phase. So you find oil dispersed over the water. So the examples of emulsions is mayonnaise, egg yolk, and cream. Now, the size of the particles. When you see the size of the particles in this, you can find the size of the oil droplets is from 1 to 10 micrometers or submicrometers. The process of converting this immiscible liquid to a stable emulsion is known as emulsification. So if I need to bring this to a stable emulsion, I need to add the third ingredient. The third ingredient is known as emulsion, and the process is known as emulsification. Now, emulsifiers are commonly found in peanut butter, ice cream, coffee whiteners, margarine, or low-fat spreads, biscuits, toffees, cakes, frozen desserts, bread, as well as chewing gums. Now, types of emulsions. Usually types of emulsion we'll talk about based on the sources. There are two kinds of emulsion. One is natural and second is a man-made emulsion. Natural emulsions is milk, cream, butter and egg yolk, whereas man-made or synthetic emulsions are the ones which are artificially made, that is margarine, ice cream, cake batter and cream soup. Next, types of emulsion based on stability. Earlier we have done types of emulsion based on sources. Now we are doing type of emulsion based on the stability. So there are two types. One is temporary emulsion, where you can understand it separates into different layers on standing. Like, I'll give you the same example as oil and water. So I'm putting the pressure, I'm agitating it, I'm leaving it. So till I agitate, you can find that it is getting miscible. But after some time on standing, again you find the oil particles. So this is said to be a temporary emulsion. Example, French dressing. Coming to the permanent emulsion. Permanent emulsion, these are stable when they are left to stand. Example, mayonnaise. Next, types of emulsion based on dispersed and continuous phase. There are two types of emulsion. First is oil in water emulsion, which we call it as OW, and water in oil emulsion, which is WO. So let us talk about the first emulsion, that is oil in water emulsion. Now, you can see in this picture where you find oil particles is dispersed. So it is said to be dispersed phase, whereas water is a continuous phase. So you find water, which is a continuous phase, and oil particles, which is dispersed in the water. So we call it as a dispersed phase. Now in this, we are going to talk about three products. Number one is milk. Now milk is a natural emulsion, as let me go back to the slide, which we have done. Natural emulsion, which includes milk, cream, butter and egg yolk. So milk is a natural emulsion and it is an oil water emulsion and a permanent emulsion. But when you talk about various kinds of milk, like homogenized milk and non-homogenized milk, non-homogenized milk, fresh milk exhibit creaming, because of which it divides into two layers. One is a rich fat layer and second is poor layer. So when you churn it and leave it for some time, automatically the particles which are lighter will move upward and the particles which are heavier will move downwards. So this tends to rise and forms clusters, which can be separated by centrifugation. Now talking about homogenized milk. Homogenized milk forms finer droplets and prevents creaming. Next, mayonnaise. Mayonnaise is again an oil water emulsion and a permanent emulsion. It is thick and creamy. The ingredients which are used in preparing mayonnaise are vinegar and egg yolk. Now egg has got lecithin, which is a natural emulsion. So automatically it becomes a permanent emulsion. Next, French dressing. Already we have discussed earlier, French dressing is a temporary emulsion. So generally it is a temporary emulsion and oil water emulsion, and the ingredients which are required to prepare this French dressing is oil, vinegar, mustard powder and paprika. Mustard and paprika lowers the interfacial tension when shaken vigorously. So the moment you add in these ingredients and start shaking it, so you find it is emulsified. But after you leave it, after you stop whisking it or shaking it, then you will find again oil as well as vinegar separates from each other. So this is said to be a temporary emulsion. Talking about the next, that is water in oil emulsion. So here you can see oil droplets become the continuous phase and water becomes the dispersed phase. So in this we will talk about the two products. One is butter. When you talk about butter, butter is a water oil emulsion. It is a permanent emulsion as well as you can say natural emulsion also. But butter contains 80 to 82% fat. But when you are churning and kneading cream to break the interfacial film, then this converts from oil water to water oil, and this can be facilitated by adding warm or chilled water. Second is margarine. Margarine is again water oil emulsification, which is a permanent as well as a man-made or synthetic emulsion. Production of margarine involves emulsification of oil and water phase. Finally, it is plastification. So you take an example of plastification. When you see butter, it's in the refrigerator, it is solid in state. If you leave that butter at room temperature, specifically during summer season, and you start applying on the bread, then it forms a, it spreads very easily. So it is said to be plastification. You can see the picture here where you can find mayonnaise with the emulsifier. So it is, becomes a permanent emulsion, whereas you can find mayonnaise without an emulsifier, because of which you can find it separates into two layers, that is rich fat as well as poor fat. Next, emulsifying agents and their role in the food industry. Emulsifiers is a surface active agent that confers stability by decreasing interfacial tension by forming protective layer around each droplet. So the emulsifier that you are using, these are surface active agents. Now the emulsifier, if it covers the complete droplet which is dispersed, then it is said to be a good emulsifier. Sometimes the emulsifier that we are adding will not cover the complete droplet. In that cases, they are said to be a not a good emulsifier. So not all surfactants are the good emulsifier. Now, division of emulsifier. So food emulsifier, so you can take an example of surface active agents which contains both hydrophilic, which is water loving, and lipophilic, which is fat loving. So egg yolk contains lecithin, which is a phospholipid. Next, finely divided particles, no surface active properties adsorb and prevent collisions. Example, mustard powder as well as pepper powder. So I'll give you the example here. You can see water and oil, and you can see mustard mixed with water. So this is observed on the surface. The last one in this is hydrocolloids, which includes pectins, gums, increases the viscosity of the continuous phase, which helps in stabilizing oil water emulsion. So in today's unit, we have been talking about what is emulsion. Then we have been talking about temporary and permanent emulsion, natural as well as man-made or synthetic emulsion. Then we have been talking about oil and water, water and oil. Then role of emulsifiers in the food industry. So I hope it is clear. In case of any doubts, you can always check with me on WhatsApp. Thank you.